Aurasma is one of a range of augmented reality apps. It's fantastic for creating your own auras and making information in the class much more interactive.
Let's have a look at how we can make our own auras using Aurasma. So first of all, you need an image that you want to point at. It can be something like a magazine cover. It could be a real world object. So there are actually auras that have been set up where you might point the iPad at Times Square in New York, and then a video or an interactive element will actually pop up. So they've got ones where like a Godzilla creature will actually walk through the image on your iPad through Times Square. The ones I do for my classes are obviously a lot simpler. So I'm going to use this magazine cover and hopefully have a video that pops up and plays. So what we first need to do, if we look at the icons we have on the Aurasma screen, there's an information tab that helps you with all of the tutorial type stuff. So that'll bring up tutorial items. There's also an antenna icon, and that brings up another menu, auras that I've previously made, super auras, which are ones that will work anywhere on anything using Aurasma. So in America, Aurasma users could point it at a $20 bill and it will bring up some sort of aura. You can actually set location auras. So when people are near a certain location, it'll tell you if there are any auras in the area. You can link to various channels. You can make your own channel with your auras and also link to other people's, and you can subscribe to different channels. So I've got a work colleague who made a couple of auras for our presentation, my iPad presentation at a school conference, and I subscribe to theirs. But to make one, first you need to choose an image. So if we click on the camera with the plus button, it'll then bring up a square. So you use the camera on the iPad, point it at the image you want, get it in range, and there's actually a bar in this corner. When you change the object you're pointing at, the bar moves, and when that bar gets into the green zone, it tells you you've got quite a good image in the screen that will be fairly easy to recognize. So I'm going to get that to a good position, and then you click the take button down here, the camera. So let me just do that. So once you've taken your image to be recognized, the next step is adding an object or animation to that image. So here you've got two choices. You can actually add something that Aurasma's made for you, or you can look on your own iPad and choose one of your own photos or videos. So Aurasma lets you choose. There are some animations, images, 3D objects, some videos, but I am going to instead choose something from my iPad. Takes you to your camera roll. For as an example, this is a little video I just made that'll explain what I want the students to do with the New Scientist magazine, so you can check it.
In this week's New Scientist magazine, I would like you to read the article on page 45 about greenhouse gases and global.
Okay, so I'd actually like to use that, so I'm going to click Use. It will then take a moment to compress the video, put it into a format that I can use. It's then going to ask me to give a name to my aura that I've made, so I'll call it New Scientist. And then we can actually set, if we click Next, it'll ask us where we want the aura to appear. So you can move it, you can change the size of it, and you can rotate it as well. So I'm going to put it up the other way so that it opens the right way up. Okay, so now I've set that. If I click Save, it's going to process it, it's going to upload it to Aurasma's central database, and it will be available shortly. A little sign will pop up and tell us that it's ready to go. Okay, there we go. So now we'll use the camera on the iPad. When we've got the Aurasma app open, we'll point it at the cover of the New Scientist magazine. It should detect that image and play the video that I've set to play. So I would use this in class where students, I might ask them to do some reading of a particular magazine, and they could find out what I require them to do by viewing the video.
In this week's New Scientist magazine, I would like you to read the article on page 45 about greenhouse gases and global warming. I want you to write a short summary of the article and have it ready to present in class next lesson. So how would I use this in the classroom? A couple of examples might be if you're in science class doing some practical tasks, You could have a flyer on the bench next to the practical task. The students could point their iPad at the flyer and have Aurasma open, and it will play them a video of what you would like them to do in the practical task, or even show them a demo of how to complete the practical. You could have information posters up around the room where students point Aurasma on their iPad at the information poster, and you talk them through some of the main details on the poster. As I showed before, you could have magazine articles, things like that, that the students can point at, and it highlights the tasks you'd like them to undertake reading that article. So there's a whole range of different uses.